Let's take a look at the buyer intent tool in HubSpot. You'll need Marketing Pro or above for this. By the end of the video, I'm going to have walked you through the basics for setting it up and some of the benefits that you can get from it, and especially for your sales team. So here I am in buyer intent. You can get to it under the marketing menu, buyer intent. And I'm going to come back in a minute to this overview. This is where it all happens. We can see the visitors. These are the companies that have been visiting our websites. We have a number of websites, domains that we run in our HubSpot portal. More on that in a moment. But first of all, I want to take you through the configuration. So if we go to the configuration tab here, there's a bunch of things to go through. I'm not going to go through all of them, just the basics that you need. First of all is your target markets. If you were to click markets, it'll go to a markets section. I'll take you through that in a second. There's also visitor intent. For example, for us, if a visitor navigates to any of these pages, pricing, services, or framework, we see that as a good sign. So we call that intent. There's also some topics. I'm not going to go through that in this video. There's some settings for auto adding to your CRM and being emailed a digest daily, weekly, etc., as well as some exclusions. But I just want to take you through the target markets. If I were to click through that, it would take us to this section here. In our portal, we've only set up two markets. You can have multiple ones. Let me walk you through them. So for us, AU HubSpot, this is a very general one. Let me show you. All I'm saying is show me any company in Australia where they have a web technology of HubSpot. So if a visitor comes to the site, one of our sites that is, and they look like they're based in Australia and they use HubSpot, then they're going to appear. So 16,000, that's quite a large number of companies. What about this one? It's a little bit more specific, mid to large, because I've actually put in an employee range, again in Australia. And in fact, I've narrowed it down just to Sydney where I'm located. And again, HubSpot, some revenue ranges. So just getting quite specific with our ideal client here. I haven't included industries though, but we do actually focus on a few. So that might be something that we further refine in time. So they're the two markets that I've set up for us in our portal. Let's go back to the configuration. I've got both of them here. This intent criteria I showed before. Let's now jump back to that visitors tab and have a look what we've got. So here we have, here's the list. And what's the time frame on this? Well, this is actually in the last 14 days. So we've had, if I were to make this 100 per page, it should refill. So there's five tabs. So there's probably up to 500 companies that have visited our sites in the last 14 days. And we can see a few little labels here, whether they showed intent, whether they're already in our portal. That little HubSpot sprocket there says, yep, they're in the CRM. So there's a few that aren't. And what could we do? We can actually just have a quick look at activity. This will show the okay, they've looked at some HubShots episodes, for example. Look, they're in France. They're probably not ideal for us, but it's just an example. You can see the date and some pages. They were searching. They were obviously searching for something here and found a few different episodes that they went through, so I can get a sense what they're after. This is just at the company level, so it's not actually the specific contact or anything like that. But because there's 500 or so, let's have a SEO Bali online. That looks like spam. Let's have a look. What were they doing? Oh, they're on our Zen Create site. Contact, some graphic design. I will bet they visited the contact page and filled out some spam. Anyway, I'm getting a little bit distracted. Because there's 500, I'm like, well, what can we do now? Why don't we actually say, did they show intent? And see how there's this label with intent? It'll filter it down just to the companies that showed intent. It should be a lot smaller. Yeah, 25. So we're now down to about 50. Can see a bit of intent. And looking through this list, I actually know a few of these are customers of ours. Let's have a look at this. This is all target markets. What about if I just narrow it down even further to just in, well, let's just say AU HubSpot. I've narrowed it down. Okay, now we're down to just a handful. In fact, why don't I get rid of that one and say, what about just in Sydney? And now we're just down to one. Let's have a look at what they were looking at. You can see, okay, some of our Zen Create Out design offering and things like that. So at this point, you can imagine if your sales team were filtering this down, they could have a quick look through who was on their site. They could say, well, have we spoken with these people? Will I reach out? At this point, I could go to contacts. I won't in this just for privacy reasons, but if those contacts were already in our portal, we could actually have a look at them and then connect further. So that's quite a good overview of the tool. Let me take that out again and just bring us back here. So then the point is, well, what's if I don't want to have to go to this list all the time and check it daily manually myself? Well, there's a few things. Back on configuration, this is where these daily digests, email digests, you can actually say, I want to get an email of a monthly. You can actually set them up to be daily or weekly as well. And I'll just jump back here because one of the things that you can do, let's say I filter it down and further filter it down. There's actually other options you have. You can then save it as a view. See here at the bottom, save as a view. I've already got some views saved, so I can quickly jump in and just say, what? His target last 14 days. What about target customers? What about AU Sydney? Just see those ones. You can see only a handful in the last couple of days. But here we can actually go a little bit further because I can actually set up a workflow to create a task and send me a notification. So let's jump over now to a workflow. I'll show you what it looks like. Very easy to set up. I've just got some enrollment criteria if they've actually met one of those saved views. You know how I just said you can save views? What's if they've actually met one of those saved views? Well, it can kick off this workflow. What does the workflow do? It's very simple. Just creates a task immediately, account name or company name, depending on what the label is in your portal. And I can send myself a few details in the notes. That creates a task. And I've just got my notifications set so that any tasks that are created for me and assigned to me send me an email. So with that, I've basically set up my markets, my intent, and then whenever someone meets one of those saved views, I'll get a task and an email. So straight away, I can be notified of any company that's on our websites that is showing intent. So imagine what you can do for your sales teams with this process in place. It's a very simple way to kind of set the criteria and then notify and assign tasks and keep people informed. So I hope that's helpful. Let me know. There's other parts. For example, the research beta I haven't even gone to in this particular video. I can do that in future if that's of interest to you. Have a play. Let me know if you've got any questions. I'll see you in the next video.